لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. صدق الله العظيم. Respective viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا and welcome to our program. And we thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the one who made it easy for us to be one of your family, and شكرا جزيلا for all what you have said on your comment, and جزاكم الله خير الجزاء. And we'd like to thank all our viewers, those who are watching our show, inshallah. Once again, we thank you, and you're most welcome for any inquiry or any correction or any feedback. You're most welcome, inshallah. I'd like to thank our respected sisters. We got some SMSs regarding the madhab. We get different madhab. We got four madhab in Islam that they call it school of thought. That madhab, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, and Imam Malik. This four Imam, I got so many brothers, they're asking about the four Imams. And they say, what about if we don't follow the four Imams? And some will say, what is the difference between Hanafi and Shafi'i and all? Is that another section of religion or another copy of Islam or what? Now, when we talk about the madhab, we are not talking about a copy of Islam. We're talking about the practical thought of Islam. This for Imam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the professional specialist if you do not know. And we have to agree now that we do not know. Really, we don't know. We don't have the sufficient knowledge so that we can stay away from madhab or the imam or the guide. Our sisters asking that why these imams are different. Now I'm going to ask the same sister, what do you think, what differences you have on that imam? In aqidah can be different. In ibadat can be different. Only the method of ibadah. Method of ibadah, the tactic of ibadah, how to worship Allah. Yes, I know salah, and that is the salah based on the salatul Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The question again will come: why they are different? Why I don't have a copy of Islam, one copy of thought? I'm going to ask here again. Look at yourself. Look at your brothers and sisters. Look at your mother and you. Look at the creation around you. You will find it in different forms. Look at your way of looking, or your words, or your ages. You are the one person, but look at yourself 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it like that, because Deenul Islam is very flexible religion. They call us extremists. They call us very, very fundamentalists. They call us very, very hard people. We said, no. Islam is the only religion. It's very soft, flexible, and also match everyone. And there is way for you to practice Islam, which the way you like it, according this four madhab. Islam is not a very hard religion. The thought of Islam is a mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Judaism, you say, if, when your wife got menstruation, they kick her out till she come pure. When part of his clothes get dirty and pure, The only way you clean it, you cut it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very hard to Banu Israel, the follower of Moses, because they don't want to accept the message of Allah, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to them. Why I'm saying that? Because we got so many questions, say, why? I said, no, it's not, it's not mukhalafah. You know what is mukhalafah? It's not a fight. It's a very high academic opinion, different opinion. They call it like that. Sahaba, in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they got opinion. Nabi was there, and they learn it from him, but everyone is using that opinion according to the Deen of Islam or the evidence of Rasul. And Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. When the Sahaba came in the Hajj, with Hajj, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, I did throw the stone before, I say, if'al wala haraj. My wife is old, can she throw the stone before the, if'al wala haraj. Do, there is no problem, no burden. It means the maqsad, the aim of Islam is to ease the life of people, not to be difficult. Imagine we have only one madhab. So how are you going to find a way? How are you going to find a way? It's going to be a copy of Judaism, like this, it's like that. So you try to pull out, you say, no, we can't. But amongst the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a different practical way of practicing the deen of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the maqsad based, or the action based upon the sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Very, very important thing to believe, that the opinion of Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah was correct. And the different opinion of Imam Abu Hanifa regarding that also was correct for one simple reason. Two of them based on the action of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our Nabi done it like this, and he done it this way. So you take it like this. Brother and sister in Islam, first reason of that different school of thought, Imam Abu Hanifa, the madhab we call it, it's called, is the sunnah of Allah. Allah wanted it like that. Allah wanted it like that. After Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sahaba got different opinion. Abu Bakr Siddiq in a war of Murtad, those who return don't want to pay zakat. So Umar ibn Khattab said, no, we leave them, we don't fight. That is opinion. Abu Bakr Siddiq said, no, I will fight till I kill them. So what you think about these two Sahabi was they, and everyone who got different opinion for the pleasure of Allah. In amongst the Sahaba, you have two school of thought. After Rasulullah passed away, you find two school of thought. School of Sayyidina Abdullah bin Umar, and we got school of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas. These two school of thought, in a practical way, you got ikhtilaf. They find that different. And Sahaba did accept this, and some Sahaba did accept that. There's no problem. What I'm trying to say, the first reason of different madhab, Allah wanted it like that, because madhab is not another religion. It's just a way to worship Allah according to the sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's been done by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The other reason of ikhtilaf, that wonderful Quranic Arabic language. That kalam of Allah, they call it language of Quran. That words of Quran al-Kareem, it's amazing words. One word has many meaning. So now, we got chance now to get that rich meaning of one Arabic word. Language of Quran is Arabic. This type of Arabic language, it's unbelievable language, because it can accommodate kalam of Allah. There's no other language can fit the maqsad of Allah, or the intention of Allah, or the message of Allah, except the Arabic language. It's very hard. It's very hard to just look at the word and you decide like that. Got something, it's called lafzul mushtarab. One expression has plenty meaning. So the Sahaba and the Mufassirin, do you look at this one and say, okay, it means like this, means like that, means that. And they got proof from the Quran and Sunnah. They got the evidence from the Kitab of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah. Because of that differences or that type of ikhtilaf, not mukhalafa, as they say. One man, I just want to give you example how heavy and how rich the Arabic language. One Sahabi came to Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and said, "Oh Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, I swear that I will never sleep with my wife until heen." The Arabic, they say heen. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, look at this Arabic word. I just want to show you how rich that language. And he said, "Heen, yeah, sleep with your wife tomorrow." So that man, he said, "Heen, tomorrow." And he went to Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. He said, "Oh Umar, I did make qasam that I will never sleep with my wife till heen. So when I'm going to sleep?" He said, "Next year, inshallah. Same day like this day, next year." Now the man gets shocked. Say, "How come?" You say, "Like that." He moved to Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. And Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib said, "No, you know, this lady here is nearly got divorced. You will never sleep with your wife. Only in the day of Qiyamah you can sleep with her." Look at this one. Because of heen, heen, heen. Now they ask Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Three of them are right. Three of them are right. So they ask Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, say, "Why you said one night?" He said, "I got a proof." They ask Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, "Why you said one year?" He said, "I got the proof." And Sayyidina Ali said, "Also I got the proof." So now we got three proofs in different opinion. Now what going to do now? I think my cameraman asked me to stop for break. We'll continue after that, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. I'd like to thank all my friends and all our brothers for the SMS and emails. Shukran jazeelan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to practice what we are saying, inshallah. We'd like to thank all our viewers, those who are sending emails and SMS. You're most welcome for anything, inshallah. Before the break, I was talking about how rich is the Arabic language. And the Sahaba got the proof for one word, one expression from the Quran. From the Quran in different type of proof and evidence. So Sayyidina, they ask Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, "Why you said to that man, heen is tomorrow?" He said, "It's one day." He said, "Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Subhanallah, heena tumsuna wa heena tusbihun." So glory be to Allah when you wake up and when you sleep. It means day and night. So it's 24 hours. So that is from Quran, proof, evidence. No one can deny it. They asked Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, "Why you said next year?" He said, "Yeah, that heen got another meaning." "What is that?" He said, "Kalimatun tayyiba," the ayah, Sayyidina Quran, the good words is like a good tree, tu'ti ukulaha kulla heen. It gives the fruit every year, because the tree gives every year. So now they say, that's why it came to my mind, the proof, so heen is 1 year. They ask Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, "No, I didn't think about the day and the year. It came in the Quran Kareem about heen, that وَلِتَعْلَمُنَّ نَبَأَهُ بَعْدَ heen." You will know the proper meaning of the Quran in a day of judgment. Heen is in a day of judgment. One Arabic words is called heen. You got three different meaning, and three of them are correct. So imagine with that heen is just a day of Qiyamah. What are we going to do for this man there who wants his wife now? So that man run away and say, "I'll go to Abu Bakr. I love Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. This one, I like that Arabic. That one because it suits him and match his problem. And it is halal. It is correct. And nothing wrong at all." I give you that example to understand why we having four madhab. Different opinion of ulama or the mufti and all that. Why? Because Allah want to find a way for us. Makhraj. Just access to solve your problem according the Kitab and Sunnah, and Alhamdulillah. Language is the main reason that Imam Abu Hanifa said something, Imam Shafi said, because he got it in different way of meaning. The other thing also, something it's called itmi'nan. What is itmi'nan? Tranquility in the heart when he get the proof. Because these people are the wali of Allah, the friend of Allah. Really, they are saint. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for them to have that some tranquility, some itmi'nan, some pleasure when he select the proof from the Quran al-Kareem. Because Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, istafti qalbak. Ask your heart, because I can tell you a story and you will give me what I want you to tell me, but inside my heart I know that I'm wrong. The judge in court, he just believe on paper. 1, 2, 3, 4, free. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 months, 1 year in jail. That is proof and evidence. But where is the itmi'nan? Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam said, "Oh Allah, Rabbi, arini kayfa tuhyi al-maut. Oh Allah, show me how you create to resurrect the dead people." He said, "Awalam tu'min? Don't you believe?" He said, "No, walakin liyatma'inna qalbi, just to ease my heart and to please my heart, how you make it? How you make it?" So the technique, how you resurrect people from the grave. So there is something there on the four imams is called itmi'nan. Four of them, they have absolutely true itmi'nan. That's why we said to the brother and sister in Islam, be careful when you talk about the madhab. If you deny the madhab, the ulama said, you know what? If you deny, you disbelieve on the other madhab, it means you cancel evidence from Quran and the Sunnah. Be careful of that, my beloved friends, please. Because some people, they use it as a racism. Am I Shafi'i? Yeah, so I don't like Hanafi, or I don't like Maliki, I don't like Hanbali. No, no, no. You know why you don't like him? Why? If you say I don't like him, it means you don't like the proof he collected from the Quran. He said, I believe on it, but I want to practice with this one. It match me. This way, yeah, it suits my nature, it suits my culture. It suits my belief, my thought, my mentality. I like to be Hanafi, or I like to be Shafi'i like that. But never ever make kufr of the opinion of the imams. The madhab, the sahib al-madhab, four imam. Because Muslim has four madhab. We don't have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No. The other one beside these four, they call it firqa. Group or section or those who don't count them from my topic today. We have four. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, Imam Shafi, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. We have to accept the madhab. Now the question for the brother is said, can I move from one to another one and say, hey, wait. You can't. No, Sheikh, I want to be today Hanafi, tomorrow I say no. That's called fisq. You know what is fiqh? Fisq. You pull out from Jama'at al-Muslimin. No, I'm not pulling out from Jama'at al-Muslimin. I'm trying to get this one. I say no. Why are you changing? Because I running away from wajib. Because this, if Imam Abu Hanifa said, you have to do that. So now you run away because Imam Shafi said, no, don't do it. See, look at this. So your maqsad is not to solve the problem. Your maqsad is to dodge the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which some ulama said, this man can be fasiq. So you have to stick with the madhab one way. Why am I saying that? Because really, here in Africa and some of other country, they take it as a political differences. It's like a opposition party and this one. No. That is a high, beloved ikhtilaf differences. Very high academic ikhtilaf and that different opinion. It's for you. Not for anyone else. They say, لَوْلَا اخْتِلَافُ الْأَذْوَاقِ لَبَارَةِ السِّلْعَةِ. They say in Arabic, a saying like that. If we don't have different type of taste and opinion, the goods in the shop, it will go off. Someone like chicken, another one like beef, another one like mutton, another one like fish. If all of us, we like fish, so the chicken the business will go down. What I'm trying to say, brother and sister in Islam, it is knowledge, it is a'mal al-Nabi, it is Islam, it is a proven from Quran and Sunnah and four of them are correct. Because you know the Quranic words is like a piece of diamond. It reflects from different angle. He saw it from here. It was right. And Imam Abu Hanifa saw it from here. It was right. Saw it from here. Got plenty. Why the diamond is expensive more than the glass? Because really it has that shining or brightening or reflection from all the angles and uncountable angles. That's why that necklace is shining more than the glass or any crystal or anything. What I'm trying to say, it is deen. Enjoy your madhab. It is correct. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you. They say, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the professional if you do not know. And believe me, we do not know. That's why we need the madhab, because very easy. Let me tell you about Imam Abu Hanifa. Why Imam Abu Hanifa is authentic reference for the Muslim. And Imam Shafi also, and Imam Malik. But let me tell you about Imam Abu Hanifa. They call him al-Imam al-A'zam. He gave a kitab, it's called Fiqh al-A'zam. When you talk about fiqh, you must mention Imam Abu Hanifa. Imam Abu Hanifa, his ustaz, teacher, there were about 4,000 teachers. Can you believe a student's learned by 4,000 people? It's a big amount of number. 93 of them are tabi'een. They did see the Sahaba, the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So who's going to hate Imam Abu Hanifa now? Someone learned like this. He said that the most learned person is the one who understands the ikhtilaf between the madhahib, the one who understands the differences in the Islamic thought. It means this ilm, it's called ilm al-ikhtilaf. If you want to know that man is alim or not, he must know what is the differences or what is that different opinion for the ulama. So he is an alim. But to just live on that cave alone, you won't know what is going on. Right. Imam Abu Hanifa was not only a scholar of fiqh, but he was a leader of the ummah. He got a certain attitude with his students till he sponsored his students, Imam Abu Yusuf, with his children and wife, for 20 years. Which teacher now sponsor his students, make sabr for his students for 20 years? Definitely is a pious person. Very intelligent imam. Very genius. If people don't come and ask him, he suggests the question to give it to himself. And the ulama said 60,000 fatwa he suggested before the time. That's why when you find the fatwa of Imam Abu Hanifa, says, Subhanallah, it was not in his time. He just suggests the fatwa and he give answer, 60,000 fatwa, and he give the answer for the six. Who gave the question? Himself, who answered it, just to offer the people before they ask him. Really is genius, intelligent. They say people were sleeping. They don't know the value of fiqh till Imam Abu Hanifa came and wake up the ulama about that Mubarak science or knowledge. It's called the knowledge of fiqh. When I say fiqh, it means halal and haram. Fiqh is about do and do not do, or the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to practice the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam al-Shafi'i said people are depending on fiqh on Imam Abu Hanifa. So believe me, this man deserves to be followed, because really a'lamun nas, we are nothing besides Imam Abu Hanifa. Once again, my cameraman fighting for break. We'll continue after that, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back to our program. I'd like to thank all our viewers and welcome our new viewers. Ahlan wa sahlan, and welcome to all our brothers and sisters in Islam. And on behalf of our staff here, we say shukran that you are tuning to ITV. Once again, we thank you for emails and SMSs. And today we're talking about our beloved madhab, school of thought of the Muslim, where the million of Muslims are enjoying that knowledge or that science or that ilm from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, based on the kitab and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now when we talk to our beloved one, Imam al-Shafi'i. Imam al-Shafi'i, his grandfather, grandfather, forefather, number four. He did meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he saw Nabi Muhammad. I think it's a fresh knowledge then. Fresh knowledge. And believe me, Imam al-Shafi'i, they call him al-alim, al-amil al-abid. Scholar, practice, and worship Allah. So we call him a wali of Allah. And we say, Ala inna awliya Allah la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. If you want to know who's the wali of Allah, you must remember Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, and you must remember the alim who did practice what he learned and put it in action, Imam al-Shafi'i. Imam al-Shafi'i is not only his mind, it's his tongue, the way he preach. His voice, it's enough for people to get hidayah. Very melodious voice. And people, when they have stress, they say, let's go to that young boy to read for us and to talk to us. Just a wonderful image from and the signal from that preacher to the ummah. You just sit and enjoy his talking, you build up your spirit. So it's not only knowledge, but is akhlaq and spirit. That al-alim, al-abid, al-amil. The significance of Imam al-Shafi'i, he knows Arabic language well. Top speaking in Arabic, and he corrected the tribe of Arabs in his time for how to say Arabic and how to speak and how to write the poetry, how to mention that poetry. Very young mufti, young boy, but he got knowledge, freshness of knowledge. He was 13 years old, and he memorized the kitab of Imam Malik al-Muwatta. That is, you know how long was Imam Malik was writing that his kitab? 40 years. This young boy, Imam Shafi'i, memorized it by the age of 13 years. He was, as I said, from that age, he was a mufti already. So born in fatwa. He joined and he accompanied Imam Malik as a student for 16 years. Can you believe that? Just one on and off, day and night with one alim for 16. And we call him, this man, Nasir al-Sunnah. Imam al-Shafi'i said, he's the one who protect the Sunnah to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to say, Quran and Sunnah are one piece. We don't accept anyone who favor the Quran and neglect the Sunnah. Who look after the Quran and neglect the Sunnah, because Imam al-Shafi'i said that Quran from Allah and the Sunnah is also from Allah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received it by Jibril. So we call him Nasir al-Sunnah. The significance of Imam al-Shafi'i, he could make a certain unity or combination between two important things in knowledge. They call it Ahlul Ra'i and Ahlul Hadith. The personal opinion and the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the conflict, the fight, if that Maulana or that Mufti or that Sheikh put his opinion, and it comes the hadith and oppose that opinion. But Imam Shafi'i, with his intelligent effort, he did combine between opinion and the hadith of Rasulullah, they match one another. What a lovely thing, solve a lot of problem. Right. He said to his students, to seek knowledge is more important than to make extra ibadah. Because once you make knowledge, you gain the barakat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also you will make nafil ibadah. So because ilm itself is ibadah. So he said, talabul ilm afdalu min salati at-tatawwu. Extra salah. Right. As I said, alim, amil, abid, wali of Allah, one third of his night, study and teach. The second third, salah. The last third, or the next third, is to sleep. So his night, it's ibadah and knowledge. They ask him, are you happy? Imam Shafi'i, are you happy? He said, how can I get happiness while 8 things are running after me? Allah with his command, Rasul with his sunnah, I need to practice his sunnah, Allah bil Quran, command of Allah, Rasul with Sunnah, Dahar, time with calamity, this dunya running after me with calamity, my children running after me, seeking rosy, rizq, sustenance, Malaika are running after me to write good and bad which I'm doing. Imam Shafi said like that. Nafs with a desire, shaitan with waswasa, and malakul maut waiting for me to take my soul. So how are you going to rest? We got a lot of work to do. Imam Shafi'i, we call him Nasir al-Sunnah, al-Wali, 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 the Wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see now, you can't now differ between these two imams because really, it's amazing. Anyone who followed this imam, he got a good taqdeer of Allah. And the one who followed this imam, Abu Hanifa, he's the lucky one, the one who got the good taqdeer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll go to another star, Imam Malik. They say, لا يفتى ومالك في المدينة. There's no one can give fatwa while the Malik situated on Medina. You can't. You can't. Why? Because really he's better. Imam Malik, he started knowledge, his auntie sent him to study. He began to give fatwa by the age of 17. This boy is starting very early. It means there was no time for nonsense. Shabun nasha'a fi ibadatillah. 700 alim were asking him while he was there by the age of 40. Can you believe 700 scholar in his time used to come and seek knowledge by him and question and find an answer from him by the age while he was the age of 40 years. Why he's very special? Because he got a sharp memory to memorize. Imam Malik, he knows how to memorize, which is our problem. 40 hadith in one gathering. You just get 40 hadith in one gathering. So Imam Shafi'i said, definitely Malik is my ustaz. He said like that, straight. He said, I'm just a student from Malik. He never ever read the hadith or mentioned the hadith or wrote the hadith without purity, wudu, must be clean. Because when he mentioned the name of Rasulullah ﷺ, he's shivering, his face turned yellow, because he feels that he's in front of him. So Imam Malik, we call him Al-Alim Al-Khashi'a, the one who got fear of Allah and full respect of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn al-Mubarak, Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak, he said, if you ask me to choose Amir of Islamic nation, with no hesitation, I will choose Malik. I will use Malik to be Amir, a leader of the Muslims. Not only scholar, but political leaders, social leaders, a man, a leader of the entire Muslim on this earth will be Imam Malik. Right. Why he's very famous? Because he was in Medina. So why famous in Medina? Because of Hajj. International scholars come, they meet Imam Malik. So that's why he become very famous and he got a lot of students, many students, international students because of Hajj. When you go to Medina, you meet him. That's why he's well known. Why he got so many students again? Because really, he taught from this age, Mufti, from the age of 17 till the age of 19. So I think he's a long term. Is Muammar, is old age, this one, but he taught till the age of, they say 1,400 students, international students. They learn by Imam Malik. He spent 40 years to write his kitab, Muwatta, and meaning of Muwatta, ease life of people. The ease of life of people. Oh, Muwatta, simplicity of Islam, or Muwatta, he said, people make it easy for people to understand Islam. That kitab is really, Imam Shafi'i spoke about it. There's no kitab guaranteed to have the accurate knowledge or the significant knowledge more than the Muwatta, because it was very easy for ulama to take from it, and also 70 alim approve it in his time. We'll come to our beloved Imam Ahmad been humble. I just give you a little bit of each to understand that it was not a political differences. My intention today is just to prove to the Ummah it was not a fight. It was not a war. A different thought of academic opinion, each and every one based in authentic proof and evidence from Quran and Sunnah. So you have no way to criticize one madhab or to deny or to run away from that madhab. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, we know that this man, we call him the man of hadith, muhaddith. Why we say muhaddith? Because he loved the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Again, my cameraman troubling me, ask me for a break. We'll continue after that, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. And once again, we thank you that you're tuning to our show. And my cameraman and all our friends in the studio, they are passing, conveying for you salam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of them. And once again, we thank all our friends here on the studio for helping me. And shukran jazeera, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to pass the message of Islam, inshallah. Before the break, I was talking about our beloved Imam, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. And when we talk about Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, we talk about that madhab which based on hadith. When we talk about hadith, it means Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal loved the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And one thing more, the action of Sahaba. But the one who is humbly, we don't call him Salafi, because I know my friend is going to say, oh, you Ahlul Hadith. No, no, are you Salafism? And I say, no, 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 I'm talking about the madhab, the pure madhab, which is accepted by the Ummah. It's called madhab Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. That is a madhab. So now you tell me about Shia, you tell me about this, you tell that is not falling on that four madhab, which is my discussion today. Muhaddith, the one who knows more than 2,000 hadith, that Mukathirin even, and he got one quality. He loved the hadith and aqwal al-sahaba, the saying of the sahaba and a'mal al-sahaba. That's why we call him Sahib al-Qawlayn. He's the man of two opinion. He said, if the two Sahabi mention the proof here, he mentioned it. But he doesn't take one of them. He just leave you like this. Say, Abdullah ibn Abbas said like that, and Abdullah ibn Umar said like that, and that's it. When he issued a fatwa, or his opinion, based on hadith and action of Sahabat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Especially on ibadat, the mas'ala or the fiqh of ibadat. Salah, zakah, you know the pillars of Islam, hajj and all that. Don't put his own. He say no. Nas, text, evidence from the Quran and hadith, and action of sahabi. Khalas. He said we cannot worship Allah with our ijtihad. Otherwise, if you make ijtihad on ibadah, it means we are God or we are prophet. You got wahi or something. You must sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray as you saw me praying. So he just closed that subject. Do not suggest your opinion in the time of worshipping Allah. Like in Ramadan, on salah, hajj, you know, zakat. No. You must stick with the text. Evidence from Quran and Sunnah, and that was the main point of Imam Ahmad. But he was very flexible on mu'amalat. In the other thing, besides ibadat, was very easy. He was not extremist. He was very hard here on ibadat, which he was keen to worship Allah as is. اتقوا الله حق تقاته وعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين. He was so accurate on ibadat, worshiping. But for mu'amalat, he was very flexible. We call him the man of Taysir. Taysir, he is the life of people. If you look at his fatwa, there's no hard fatwa. He said, they ask him, why you stick on the hadith? He said, because hadith will never change. Fatwa will change. Opinion will change. Today, someone give you hadith, it remains till the day of Qiyamah. But tomorrow someone give his opinion, can change tomorrow. How many times we change our opinion because we got the new evidence, the issue or the matter is a bit clear, and all of that. The other thing, that's why he in his aqaid and ibadat, he was very, very extremist, very hard. Quran, makhluk or kalam Allah. Allah created Quran or it's from ever? He said from ever. Locked him 28 months, still repeating the same thing. He said, I will never change that because it touched the aqaid, the belief of the Muslim, the thought of the Muslim, faith of the Muslim, and the ibadat. He said, if you find any person loves Imam Abu Hanifa, it means this man who loves Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, if anyone loves Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, it means that man practice Sunnah. Practice Sunnah, proper Sunnah. This Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, he memorized, you know how many? Million hadith. With the reference and with the narration and sanad, they call it sanad. Can you believe this? He said to his students, give me the reference, I give you the hadith. Give you a hadith, I give you the reference. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. How he was work? He was working as porter, carry the stuff for the people at night with two coin. One coin for knowledge, one coin to eat and survive. He doesn't like people to mention him at all. He said, no, what a lucky person, the one who's unknown. When the people come to listen to him, he was so worried and concerned. He said, I don't want to be known. No, I don't want fame and name. That is a good quality of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. And he said, I never ever wrote a hadith before I practiced it in my lifetime. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. A million hadith? He practiced million hadith? Oh, oh. And then, if he practiced million hadith, it means this man, his life was fully the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, he used to have in his gathering 5,000 listeners. 500 they are writing. And 4,500 just to look at this man and to see his akhlaq and his charisma. Subhanallah, subhanallah. Knowledge. He practiced million hadith in his lifetime. He practiced, he put it in action. So definitely he got a very amazing charisma. He was a friend of the poor people. He was the friend and he leaning a lot to the poor people. And he said he used to read salah in a day, 24 hours. And if you calculate his salawat and his sujood al-ruku'ah, 300 rak'ah. 300 rak'ah he gave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made hajj on foot two times, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. And he married, he said, I married for 40 years. I have no differences with my wife, even in one word. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. Imam Abu Dawood, he said, I never ever heard Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal mentioning worldly things or dunya or his personal worldly things in a gathering, on his majlis. It's like when we sit on the class, on the masjid, we say, no, I have a car and my father got a house. No. His kalam, his talk is deen. Now I want to remind my brother and sister in Islam. What do you think about the four imam now? Are they really enemy of one another? Did they fight to one another as the way the follower of the madhab nowadays they fight? And this nowadays they say, no, Shafi'i don't read behind Hanafi Salah. The imam is Hanafi and this one is Shafi'i. We do love our four imam. We practice the madhab which suits our condition. But with the main thing in our heart and our mind, that we don't make kufr for the opinion of the other alim or other madhab. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our life with the ni'mat of understanding of deen. It's not a different type of religion. It's not another copy of Islam. It's just a technique of ibadah. Like this, like that, It's been done by your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to reward our beloved Imam, Imam Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man. And when we talk about Imam Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man, I remember that he is the only Imam. He read Quran in one rak'ah. If he finished khatam of Quran, the full Quran in one rak'ah. You see, people spend the whole month of Ramadan to just finish one round. But how come? And he was a businessman. Now, Imam Abu Hanifa, he bought two clothes. So with 210, two. So he sold one with 200. So his friend, I said, can you sell me for the other one? The other one, he said, yeah, 10 ren, or 10 dirham. He said, are you joking? He said, no. Because I bought it for 210, I sold that one for two, that is 10 for you. He said, no, make profit. He said, no, I don't make profit from my friends. You are my friends. I don't make profit. So we tell our Muslim brothers here, please, if you are Hanafi, so fear Allah, because how come Imam Hanifa refused to make money from his friend? I mean, he sell it with a cost price. He said, really? It was two. I sell one for 200. One there, so 10 rand left on the price, so take it for the 10 rand because that is my cost price. Alim, Abid. Imam al-Shafi'i, it's amazing Alim, and also Abid. If you want to know how to worship Allah, not only about halal, haram, if you want to know the hikmah, the wisdom, we call him Idris of the Ummah. Because Imam al-Shafi'i knows how to speak. Nabi Idris al-Islam knows. Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, he knows how to keep quiet and listen to people. They say the wisdom is 100, 90% to listen, and 10% is to think, not to talk. Imam Malik is the man of love of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He loved his Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not only that, he was very intelligent. Very intelligent. Imam Malik, he knows his kitab is like mathematics. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As I said, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal is the man of loving the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why we said to the brother and sister in Islam, study more about your madhab, but do not deny the other madhab. Love the A'imma, Al-Arba'a, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the right and the correct practical deen, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us in a day of Qiyamah with our Imam, our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Unfortunately, our time is up. We'll continue, inshallah, next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله لا إله